thanks.
Tree to honor the great cycle of life and death. Come, every member of our clan, living, dead, and undecided, and let us celebrate what it is to be an Addams. Come to me, my luscious wife, oh, she of skin so pale, eyes so black, and dress cut down, to Venezuela. And tell us what it is that every Addams hopes for.
Darkness, grief, and unspeakable sorrow.
I love it when you talk sexy. When you're an Addams, you got to feel a little moonlight. When you're an Addams, you need to feel a little chill. You have to see the world in shades of gray. You have to put some in your day.
That's the way
when you're an Addams. You got to have a sense of humor. When you're an Addams,
you need to have a taste for death.
Who cares about the world outside and what it wants from you? When you're an Addams, you do what Addams always do.
When you're an Addams, you need to really love your wife
several times a day. You're happy when your toes are in the mud.
You smile in the moment you spill blood.
Ow! When you're an Addams,
you need to grab a bow and arrow.
our beloved ancestors. Why do we do this?
Because living or dead, family's still family. Beloved ancestors, back to your crypt.
It's locked.
That's right. We have a problem.
His name is Lucas. Lucas Beinke, and I'm in love.
That's right. Little Wednesday Addams, that irrepressible bundle of malice who had poisoned her own brother just for a ride in the ambulance, has grown up and found love.
Oh, Wednesday, I just want to lock you up in a little white cottage with a picket fence and an apple tree.
I like the part about being locked up.
So here's the deal. Gather around. I'm not letting you back in that crypt until love triumphs. So who is this Lucas fella? Is he worthy of her? Do they really love each other? What is love, anyway? Does this rash look serious to you? So many questions about love. But when you think about it, is there anything more important? Let's not talk about anything else but love. Let's not talk about anything else but love. Can't we talk about lofty goals, mating souls, altering minds and faltering roles? Let's not talk about anything else.
Fight, sir! Fight like a man! Ha! 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 Feel the kiss of my Spanish steel! Ha! 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 Foiled again. Damn your lightning reflexes.
Gomez, look.
Ah, flowers. Who would send something so tasteless?
The most precious gift there is, more goodylicious than gold, is that blessing we call friendship, whether new or very old.
Goodylicious? Who talks like this?
The Beinekes, Wednesday's friend Lucas and his family. They're coming for dinner tonight.
Wednesday's friend, Lucas?
Yes.
But Lucas is a boy's name?
Yes.
Wednesday has a friend who's a boy?
It's nothing, darling. Puppy love. Put these in water.
Mom, Dad, I shot dinner.
Oh, Wednesday, that's lovely. Wherever did you find it?
Petting zoo?
Ah.
Oh,
Thank you, dear. Come, Lurch. We'll whip up something really special, and this time we'll actually cook it. Oh, Gomez, guests for dinner. Fresh meat.
Daddy, I have something very important to tell you.
What?
Can you keep a secret?
Of course.
Look.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say that looked like an engagement ring.
Oh, Daddy, Lucas wants to marry me.
What?
Lucas Beinecke loves me, and he wants to marry me.
Do you want to marry him?
Yes, I think so.
You think so?
Well, I've never even met his parents, and he's never met mine, and I just need to be sure.
That he's the one?
That the families can get along. I mean, he has to know what he's getting into.
What do you mean?
I'm saying we're who we are, and they're from Ohio.
Ohio? A swing state?
That's what I mean.
You're right. We should do something. Let's go tell your mother.
No!
What? But we have to tell your mother.
Daddy, she'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
You don't want me to tell your mother you're getting married?
After dinner, when we're all friends, then we'll tell her.
But I've never kept anything from your mother.
Daddy, please!
But!
If you love me!
But!
Do you love me, Daddy?
There are two things I would never do. Say no to my wife, say no to my daughter. So what exactly should I do? Do you realize what you're asking me to do?
Daddy, one tiny little secret. Please, please.
Okay, sure, I won't
tell
your mother.
Thank you, Daddy.
Oh, no problem.
Our little secret, right?
Yes, our little secret.
There's something wrong with Wednesday.
Ah, what do you mean?
She's in the kitchen smiling. Like this. Maybe it's this boy.
This boy? Don't be silly. Ha! I say. And double ha. Ha ha! You yourself said puppy love. Now come, my love. I have an urge to go upstairs.
Gomez?
On the other hand, she is a lovely young woman. Like you were. Are. Like you are. She could even fall in love and get married, just like you did.
Don't be silly. I'm much too young to have a married daughter.
Married? I never said anything about getting married.
And besides, she'll have lots of boys.
How do you know?
Because she's my daughter.
Yes, but what if, and I have no reason to say this, but what if she did find someone who stole her heart?
Don't be ridiculous. When that happens, I'll be the first to know. Wednesday tells me everything, just like you do.
There are three things I would never do. Lie to my wife, lie to my daughter, or tell the truth to either one.
Gomez, you do tell me everything, don't you?
Of course.
Oh my, you're perspiring.
I'm what?
I hope you're not coming down with a case of liar's shingles.
Oh, no. No.
I think Wednesday and I should have a little chat.
Like a bull in the ring, like the moderate right wing, I'm trapped. Like a fly in my tea or the New York DMV, I'm trapped. With my wife to my left and my daughter to my right, any thought of my escaping should be scrapped. I could choose, sing the blues, but no matter what I do, I'm trapped, trapped, trapped. Like a boat in a lock or a cuckoo in a clock, I'm trapped. Like a corpse in the ground or like theater in the round, I'm trapped. I could lie, I could spy, I could simply up and die, but I fear the dice I've rolled have finally crapped. Do I beg, do I rage, or stay safely in my cage? How trapped, trapped, trapped? How can I keep a secret from the woman I adore? The bitter breeze that keeps me here and coming back for more. She strokes the Addams fire, she harbors each desire. I never tell her lies, but when my daughter cries, how can I be expected then to turn the other cheek? Should I not be her hero instead of sniveling and weak? I'll find the root that's true. Tell me what I must do. Do I gripe? Do I groan? Would I rather pass a stone? Trapped. Oh, I've gone wild, crazy child. Little me unreconciled. I'm trapped. If I'm wrong, I'll be strong and I'll try to get along. Or I'll fail, have to bail, send my coffin to the nail. If I napped, if I snapped, maybe dinner would be scrapped. Then I wouldn't be trapped. Hi-ya! Trapped! Yeah! Trapped!
Sometimes, I just want to rip his flesh off, eat him up till there's nothing left. I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in one position. See my face, I'm enthused. Suddenly, however, I've been puzzled. Bunny rabbits make me want to cry. All my inhibitions have been muzzled, and I think I know why. I'm being pulled in a new direction, but I think I like it. I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. Through my painful pursuit, somehow birdies took root. All the things I detested, impossibly cute. God, what do I do? Pulled.
Wow, you've got some real issues.
Fly away, little birdie! Mother always said be kind to strangers, but she doesn't know what they destroy. I can feel the clear and present dangers when she learns that the boy has got me pulled in a new direction. I think I like
that. Dad, it's good.
I think I like
that. Do it again.
I'm being pulled in a new direction. This feeling I know is impossible, so I'll confide that I've tried, but I can't let it go. It's disgustingly true. Puppy dogs with droopy faces, unicorns with dancing mice, sunrise in wide open spaces, Disney World, I'll go there twice. Butterflies at picnic lunches, bunches of chrysanthemums, lollipops and Christmas Eve and Christmas Eve, sugar plums, string quartets and chia pets and afternoon bananas lit, angels watching as I sleep, Liberace's greatest hits. I've got me pulled in a new direction. If I keep insisting, I'll stop resisting. I've got
It is the boy.
Ah, well, yes, but I don't think it is going to be such a big
deal. Puppy dogs? Disney World? She's in no state to entertain guests.
We have to cancel this dinner.
What? No.
What?
We can't cancel this dinner.
Why?
Because then there won't be a dinner.
Gomez, do you love your daughter? Do you care for her mental well-being?
Of course.
Do you want her to be put on heavy medication and spend the rest of her days hating us because we let her ruin her life?
There are four things.
Gomez! Would you stop that?
Look, I think we should have this dinner.
But why?
We've got to show her off to the world.
Are you out of your mind? Have you seen the world lately? Now stop prattling and go tell her that dinner is off.
But Kara...
You're the father. The father is the counselor. And if after 25 years of marriage, you can't do this one thing for me, well, then I just don't know what.
Okay, family meeting. About tonight. Now, first we have drinks. Like, hi, nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Okay, and then we'll want to see the house. And then at 8 we'll have dinner. And they can be back at the hotel by 9:30.
Wednesday, your father has something he needs to tell you.
Actually, Paloma, your mother and I, well, we've had some second thoughts.
What about?
This dinner. It all seems so quick.
It's not quick. Oh, please, Daddy, it's just a dinner, and they're dying to meet you. And I promise, Lucas, and you know how I hate to break a promise.
Yes, Paloma, but your mother and I, we...
Daddy, I'm your only daughter and your eldest child. And if you can't do this one thing for me, then I just don't know what.
Maybe just a little dinner.
Thank you, Daddy!
Well, it seems I've been outvoted. So dinner it is. Drinks, dinner, and then the game.
Oh, God, please, no, not the game.
But it's family tradition.
It's my dinner.
Well, it's my house, darling. Drinks, dinner, and the game.
One out of two, Paloma, don't push it.
Then can we at least all act normal?
Define normal.
Shh. Normal is an illusion, darling. What's normal for the spiders, a calamity for the fly.
Mother, please. They're normal people, not like you, not like me. Please, can't we be an average family? One normal night, that's all I want. That's all I need from you. One normal house without a mouse to feed a plant or two. You must admit we're not what people call laid back. So can't we muse a bit and lose a basic black? One normal night, normal people on their way. Just one normal night. What do you say? One normal night, to be polite, to do the least you can.
One normal eve,
can you achieve a kind of common man? You have to swear to me, yes, promise to the core. It's almost 6 o'clock, they're almost at the door. On all the Addams ancestors who've ever walked upright.
Okay, Lucas, enough is enough. Give me the map.
I don't see any houses.
That's because there aren't any, Alice. We're in the middle of some godforsaken park.
Central Park, dear. Designed in 1857 by...
Wait.
What?
I know where we are. That's where I first saw her. I was lost in the park, and a pigeon dropped on my feet with an arrow in it. And I looked up, and there she was. Wednesday, with a crossbow.
A what?
A crossbow, you know.
This girl walks around with a crossbow.
It's okay, Dad. She has a permit.
Oh, good choice, son. Okay, listen up. Now, here's what's going to happen. We're going back to the hotel, and you and I are gonna have a little talk.
Be patient with him, dear. A father should support his son, and Lucas is your only one.
See what you did? Your mother's rhyming again. Let's just get back to the hotel and then...
No! One normal night. No, not one poem, not one inspiring word. One normal scene, complete routine. Tonight can't be absurd. Please don't embarrass me or be completely rude. Don't make a fuss about the house, about the food. Whoa, one normal night. I know it's big, but can't you see?
Seems like a nice young man.
Not right for each other.
Not right for each other? What do you mean, not right for each other? Was Napoleon right for Josephine? Was Nausea right for Dramamine? Were the 80s right for the drum machine? Who's to say? Who's to say? Was ballet right for Balanchine? Was polio right for the soap vaccine? Was rehab right for Charlie Sheen? Who's to say?
On a normal night, we comprehend, we'll tend her every need.
Finding the place. It looks like somebody shot out all your street lamps. Wow. Look at this place. They just move in or what?
No. This is how they live in New York. They spend all their money on rent and have nothing left for furniture.
Where?
Mal Beinecke.
Where?
This is my wife, Alice.
Blah.
And that's my son, Lucas.
Blah.
And you are?
Blah. Blah.
She's married.
Blah. Blah.
Nice talking to you. To Alice. We've landed in Weird City. I say drinks and bye-bye.
Oh, Mal. Be open to experience and welcome in the new. Reach deep in your surprise bag. There might be a gift for you.
Honey, my surprise bag is so full I could hardly lift it. That guy who patted me down at the airport, he slipped me his telephone number. I don't think I could stand any more surprises.
Come on, Dad. These are your kind of people. Real salt of the earth.
Okay. Yeah? And where are they from?
Where are we from?
Wait, there was?
Funny, you should ask.
I didn't hear the thunder.
July 13th, 1750.
The sound of
the Spanish
thunder.
Warship.
I didn't notice.
Pico de Gallo. Once commanded by my great nautical ancestor.
Okay.
Captain General Redondo Fontana Laguna Don Jose Cuervo leaves Madrid, bound for the New World. Several months later, he is still in Madrid, as Madrid is 400 miles from the nearest ocean. A stubborn man. He set sail anyway, only to sink several months later off the southern coast of Florida.
A very hostile land, infested with rattlesnakes, mosquitoes, and many retired Jewish peoples. But enough about us. Mr. Malcolm Beinecke, I presume? And the lovely Miss Malcolm Beinecke. And you must be young Lucas. Unless, of course, you are the father and, well, you are the son with a massive thyroid problem. I go too far. No matter the night. She is young. Welcome to our extremely normal home. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Gomez Florencia Addams, at your service. Now allow me to introduce my wife, La Dueña, the mother of my children. El amor de mi vida, the love of my life, Morticia.
Late, I was setting the apple pie on the windowsill to cool.
Ah, yes. That is my little woman. A duchess in the parlor and a genius in the kitchen.
Oh, Gomez.
And a gymnast in the bedroom.
So very pleased to meet you, Mr. Beinecke.
Mrs. Addams.
And Mrs. Beinecke.
Alice.
Alice.
And you must be Lucas. What a lovely name.
Thanks. I was named after my Uncle Lucas, who got lost in the woods and ate his own leg.
They don't need to know that.
No, no, it's a beautiful story.
Wednesday has a cousin who swallowed his own tongue.
Oh, he talks just like that. That's so funny.
Thank you, Mother. Hi, I'm Wednesday.
What are you wearing?
A dress. A yellow dress.
Paloma? What happened? You look like a crime scene.
Will you excuse us for a moment? I will not have that color in my house.
I'm just being normal, okay?
Darling, we don't wear bright colors. Bright colors are for people with no inner life and no imagination. Oh, look. It's everywhere.
It's a lovely dress, Wednesday. Yellow is the color of the warming sun. Yellow is the color of yumminess and fun. Why not show the world the love in which we all believe? Why not wear your heart on your sleeve for all to see? Yellow is...
Excellent! What a lovely sentiment about the color yellow. And now, look. This is Pugsley Addams, Wednesday's little brother. Just returned from Bible study? Go, say hello, Puggles.
Hello, want to make a donation?
Of course. What are you collecting for?
Just put some money in the can and nobody gets hurt.
For you boys, is it normal out there?
Ah, this is our darling grandma, the very soul of the family.
Hi, I just came from the hospital, cardiac ward. Boy, are they dropping like flies out there. I hope you're staying in shape. Grades, fresh fruit, 40 minutes on the treadmill?
I know I should, but I don't do any of that.
Well, then you're gonna die, honey. Are you ready for some football? Fester's got the ball. He's running. He's dodging. Look at that sumbitch go. He's on the 20. He's... Woo! He's fallen down. And he's... Touchdown!
This is my brother, Fester.
Nice to meet ya.
Okay, you can all say goodbye now.
Goodbye.
And now, a toast from the extensive Addams Caves.
Children, you're excused.
Lucas, come on. Dad, remember.
Not to hurry, Paloma.
I'll leave the door open, you hear?
Ooh. Are you concerned that the kids will make the beast? Well, don't you worry. Our daughter has a black belt in Taekwondo. If he tries anything, she will rip his throat out. To the children.
Excuse me, do you have a little girl's room?
We used to, but we let them all go.
Gomez!
I'm so sorry.
Come with me, dear, I'll show you.
Morticia, a grand tour for the missus. And the mister and I will go below for some guy stuff. And afterwards, dinner.
And after dinner, the game.
What kind of game?
Have you ever played charades?
Of course.
Well, it's nothing like that. Oh, I am so full of jokes tonight. Follow me. Over here we have tapestries dating way back before I was even born. It's Christ.
Did you get the flowers?
Oh, yes, and the lovely poem. Wherever did you find it?
I wrote it. No. When I'm depressed or feeling blessed, a poem will get it off my chest. They come to me, they take no time. They just pop out and always rhyme.
Well, maybe you should see someone about that.
And they're always about the one thing everyone needs and so few have.
Healthcare.
Why, love, of course.
Oh. My father won't.
Why not?
I already told him.
What? You told your father? Your father with the sword? You told him we were getting married just like that?
He's totally cool with it. Mostly.
I thought we were gonna tell them all together.
We need his help. You don't know my mother. She could really screw it up.
I'm not marrying your mother.
I know. Look. It might seem old-fashioned, but I want their blessing.
You're right. It is old-fashioned.
Lucas, do you love me?
Of course.
Then leave it to me. It's all going according to plan.
What plan? There's no plan.
That's the plan. Improvise. Keep them guessing.
You're really crazy.
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's just a simple dinner. What could go wrong? Come on.
Be patient, and soon the way will be clear. Focus your fear, and troubles all will disappear. Let's not talk about anything old.
Please don't leave us out in the cold.
Let's not talk about anything else but love.
But love.
But love.
Oh, and this is Cousin Helga from Baden-Baden.
Who's that looking over her shoulder?
Oh, no. That's her other head.
She has two heads?
Well, you know what they say.
And who's that man in the dress?
Oh, that's Aunt Herman. Wednesday's uncle, twice removed.
I don't understand.
Well, they removed it once, but it grew back. And here's Gomez and me at our wedding.
What's that?
Our wedding vows.
Oh, that's so romantic. We promise to tango at least 3 times a week.
For passion.
We promise to tell each other everything.
For truth.
Everything?
Of course.
And you're still married?
More than ever.
Boy, it sure doesn't work that way in our house.
How does it work?
Well, what's good for the gander is a nice quiet goose. If I told Mal my secrets, all hell would break loose.
Alice, I'm shocked. What kind of a marriage is it where you keep secrets?
A long one.
Secrets are the enemies of passion. Speaking true will get you through the day.
Truth is not a thing that one should ration, but I think you think of it that way. Never keep a sin inside the closet. Always give the facts a fighting chance. Every time you do, it's a deposit in the long-term life of your romance. Keep no secrets if you want him to remain your lover. Share all secrets. There's a world of things you might discover. Truth is beauty. He should always know exactly who you are. Bear your secrets, and your marriage will be healthier by far. Gomez adores me, never ignores me, always has put me first. And Alice, if he should try once telling a lie once, I'd throw him out head first. Kneeling, he'd plead, I'd reconsider.
Always the paragon.
Without a doubt.
And if he told you a lie, you'd whisper goodbye, then leave him to carry on.
That's it, exactly.
Is there no room for some discussion?
If Gomez lied?
Is there no chance you might forgive?
A lie's a lie, and lies can kill. And life can quickly go downhill. She kept a secret, and she wound up on the guillotine.
Now I see what you mean.
She kept a secret and they shot her with an M16.
That's not a pretty scene.
She kept a secret and she wound up on the cover of a magazine. Keep no secrets. Welcome honesty with no resistance. Kind of coexistence. Lies and secrets, they're the sins that keep a husband from a wife. Gomez loves me, he would never keep a secret in his
So, where does a student get the money for an engagement ring?
I work after school at the bookstore, and weekends I tutor kids at a charter school, and summers I work at my uncle's grocery store.
Is any of this true?
Most of it.
And in your time off, wise guy?
Mostly I just think about Wednesday and how much I love her, and how we could have a wonderful life together.
And what does a Lucas Beinecke become when it grows up?
Maybe a writer. Or a medical examiner.
A medical examiner, huh? Why?
You get to look at the inside of people's bodies and they don't mind because they're dead.
Where did you find him?
We found each other. It's kind of a miracle. Oh.
Gomez!
Oh my God, Daddy!
What are we gonna do?
We're just going to tell her. It is going to be fine.
You promised after dinner.
After dinner, not before anyone. It doesn't matter what we do. It is going to be fine, I promise.
What are the three of you talking about?
The weather.
The news.
The economy.
The economy.
Well, we'll be going now. See you at dinner.
Oh, Lucas, come with me. Have you ever seen a rat as big as a dachshund?
No, sir.
Well, Gomez. Come with me to the mall. Yes?
What's going on?
Nothing. We were just talking.
That wasn't talking. That was conspiring.
No, oh, no. Conspiring is more like I whisper over here and I to be
That's what you're
quiet
doing.
Querida, stop this foolishness.
You're keeping something from me.
Querida, I have never kept anything from you. And may lightning strike me where I stand if I am lying to you now.
that it should come to this.
Oh, come, Morticia. I have an urge to take you into my arms.
Not today.
But you've never turned a trip down to heaven.
Not today. I'll be in my room waiting until you're ready to share. Like a proper husband.
Morticia. Morticia, where are you going? Morticia, my love! Mia!
Put the ring on, just for a minute.
After dinner.
But what if they hate each other?
What if they don't? Be like me. Look on the bright side.
You make me so crazy.
Oh my, maybe you two should get a room.
Pugsley, stop sneaking around like that.
It's my house too, okay?
Excuse me. Why I kill my brother?
Wait. I got this. Hey, it's the Pugster. What up, little man?
Are you trying to be cool?
Uh-huh.
'Cause you're not cool.
Your sister thinks I am.
She'll get over it.
Aren't you a little young to be smoking?
Hey, I'm under a lot of stress. My sister is having an identity crisis.
We're gonna go now.
Can I come?
Sorry, Pugs. I'm with Lucas now. Bye.
But wait. What if she never tortures me anymore? How would I manage? What if she never nails my tongue to the bathroom floor? What if she walks away, leaving me a-okay, hiding each power tool? How could she be so cruel? I could stab my arm myself, could rip my tonsils out, could set my hair aflame. I could spray my eyes with mace, but face the fact without her, it wouldn't be the same.
My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours, I could teach you.
Hi, but Grandma.
Hey, stud house life.
Too long.
Tell me about it.
Hold on. What are you doing?
Restocking. Grandma's private stash. Herbs, remedies, and potions. Nature's candy. No prescription needed.
What's this one?
Peyote.
What's it do?
Makes you run around naked in the woods.
Oh, what's this one?
Buku leaf. You got someone giving you a hard time?
Maybe.
Sprinkle a little this on his toast. An hour later, he's in a padded cell screaming, I am Spartacus!
Grandma, what if there was this girl who met this person, and he's all like, I don't know, hey, it's the Pugster, what up, little man? And she's all like, golly, we're gonna go now. And they're running away together. What would you give her?
Oh, nothing. She's your sister. Be happy for her.
But what if she never gets rid of him? What if all my good times are already behind me?
That's life, kid. You lose the thing you love.
Tell me about it. What's this one?
Acrimonium. You want to stay away from this baby.
Why?
Takes the lid off the id. Brings out the dark side.
What do you mean?
Well, one swig of this and Mary Poppin turns into Medea.
I don't understand your references.
Well, stop the damn texting and pick up a book for once in a while. Now, quit whining about your sister. Start thinking about you and how you're gonna live your life. Time, my dear, is a thief. She'll steal your soul and flee on little fairy wings. and stay out of my shit, or I will rip your leg off and I'll bury you in the backyard. I love you.
Again, she'll be herself again. Lucas will leave her be, so she can torture me, just like she always did. Till then, I'm just a strange, fat kid.
Another magnificent feast, all thanks to my fabulous lady wife, from whom I keep nothing. In fact, this dinner puts me in mind of my great ancestor, Hector Escondido Chimichanga, a man hated by the church, but clever with a quip. In fact, while being burned alive, he said, "Keep it pink in the middle, a little crispy on the outside."
Thank you, dear. And now it's time to play the game.
Please, not the game. It's really late.
But it's family tradition.
Pugsley, could you just go away and die?
I will. If your boyfriend will.
Kara, maybe this game is not a good idea.
Thank you, Daddy.
No, it's a good idea. And if it isn't, then someone will be sleeping on the couch for a very long time.
This game is a great idea. It is the greatest of all ideas.
What kind of game?
Well, we call it Obligación de Revelar.
Oh, Chinese. What does it mean?
Full disclosure.
Exactly. Everyone sips from the sacred family chalice
and confesses a secret they have never told anyone.
Loosely based on the Inquisition.
And you have to absolutely tell the truth.
Or what?
Or there are consequences.
I don't think I'd be very good at that game.
Oh, I sure you would.
Oh, no.
And now Gomez will break the ice.
Oh, no.
My husband has something he needs to disclose.
No. The host goes last.
Lurch, the sacred chalice.
This is the sacred chalice from Adam's family's past. Firm in my digitalis, held fast, die cast. Here in the sweet libation, salvation resides. Fear the sweet sensation, revelation provides. Full disclosure, it's a game that we play. Let your darkest secrets give you away. Face your demons and then happily say, "I'm playing full disclosure with all these crazy happy people."
Full disclosure,
it's a hell of a thing.
Ow.
Once a favorite of the late Deng Xiaoping.
Ow.
Doesn't matter if you're right or left wing, I'm talking full disclosure.
Disclosure, full disclosure, full disclosure. Disclosure, full disclosure, full disclosure.
Yes, well, my full disclosure comes in the form of a fairy tale. Once there was a man who had two beautiful children and a beautiful wife. A humble man, I say. And yet, within his breast beat the heart of a steadfast and loyal husband who treasured his wife and worshipped the very ground she walked on. Thank you. And one day, a fox appeared and gave the man a box made of rare wood and Spanish leather. "What's in the box?" asked the kindly man, and, well, the fox said, "A little secret, but you must never, ever show anyone. So the man took this box home to his beautiful wife, and she said, let's open it anyway. And the man said to his beautiful wife, let's not push it, honey. We've got a beautiful thing going. So they never did open it. And they all lived happily ever after. Full disclosure.
Well, we'll just have to come back to you, won't we? Wednesday's turn.
Pass.
Ooh, ooh.
Ah, Fester, yes. The chalice.
I am in love.
Aww.
You're probably thinking, what could a fat, bald person of no specific sexuality know about love? But I too love. Fester loves.
Oh, Fester, who is it?
The moon. The moon. He's in love with the moon.
Yeah, that's normal.
That's the most beautiful thing I ever heard.
Oh, I haven't told her yet.
Aww.
Full disclosure.
Full disclosure.
Just embrace it and swoon.
Embrace and swoon.
Fall from grace or fall in love with the moon.
He loves that moon.
Close your sermon with a signature tune.
And call it full disclosure.
Wednesday's turn.
No.
Me. Age before beauty. The chalice. The kid and I had a little heart-to-heart before. I told him to use his time wisely. How much time have I got left? I'm 102, I have shingles and arthritis, and when I break wind, he can start the windmills on an old Dutch painting. But I still got one more round in me. Call me cougar, but 5 will get you 10. There's a couple of 90-year-old hotties out there just waiting to chow down on a grandma sandwich.
Full disclosure.
I just peed.
Oh, we should have put you down years ago.
All right, Wednesday's turn.
Not yet. Daddy, talk to her.
I've still got the fox box problem.
Wednesday, your turn. The chalice. Where's the chalice?
Yes! Now with a dash of potion, my sister blows her cool. Hopefully in slow motion, she'll drop, she'll drool. One sip of acrimonium, and then she will change. Boy, oh boy, her full disclosure's gonna be strange.
Full disclosure.
It's the moment of truth.
La, la, la.
Truth like Babe Ruth.
La 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 la.
This is torture like an impacted tooth.
Hooray for
Ah! Well, as you could see, my wife isn't herself, so we'll be on our way.
No! We're in the middle of a game, so button your lip and sit your ass down!
Alice, I think you've had enough to...
Remember how it used to be, Mal? How we'd look at each other in the middle of dinner and rush home and go upstairs, and sometimes we couldn't even wait and you just pull the car over to the side of the...
Mom!
Lighten up, Lucas! Parents do it! Live with it! Remember, Mal, when we were crazy and the future didn't exist? What happened, Mal? The guy with the Grateful Dead t-shirt, is he ever coming back? How long do I have to wait? A woman waits for marriage. A woman waits for children. She waits for her big Mal to come back home. At 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock, till it's 9 o'clock.
and there's no o'clock to ease the pain, pain she can't explain. As the woman waits in the dark for a spark that once was there, that isn't there, not ever there. Waiting and wailing and whining and waning and wanting and wasting and whoa. Waiting, fixating, debating, lose waiting, ice skating, lactating, and so. We wait to laugh. We wait to cry. We wait for every hopeful breath. Waiting for a lousy, rotting, vicious, rancid, flushed out bedded, frenzied, fatal
Wow. That was pretty dark. Even for us. Full disclosure, wow, that story was grim.
We're talking grim.
Filled with fear and loathing up to the brim.
That's quite a grim.
Just imagine being married to him.
That's it. I tried. I thought, okay, the kids like each other. Let's give it a shot. But you people are insane. You have a house where there shouldn't be a house, a zombie for a butler, and a man who's dating the moon.
Oh, I wouldn't exactly say we're dating. It's complicated.
We're simple people, Mr. Addams. We're not used to your sophisticated New York lifestyle. So with your permission, we're going back to the real America. Full disclosure. Lucas, help your mother off the table.
You were right, Lucas.
Right about what?
Thanks anyway, Daddy.
Thanks for what?
We should have just told her.
Told me what?
Lucas and I love each other, and we're getting married.
What?
Married.
That's what you kept from me?
Married.
No secrets, huh?
You let nature take its course. Chaos. I mean, is this any way to end an act? Well, actually, yes. But it'd be better if the guests couldn't leave just yet, don't you think?
Yeah!
All right, dead people, give me some weather.
It's a tornado! We'll never make it out of the park alive!
Well, Pinekees, it looks like you'll be spending the night. That is what happens when you play. Full Disclosure!
We have to talk this over for a minute.
Talk what over?
We can't just run away and get married. You said it's important that everyone got along.
And you said it didn't matter.
Yeah, but they want to kill each other. Do you want that hanging over our heads?
Boy, you sound just like your father. The root doesn't fall far from the tree, does it?
What?
Forget it.
The apple. The apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
God, you're annoying.
You know what I think? You didn't even want to get married. You just said that to stick it to your mother.
Don't psychoanalyze me, Lucas. It's a deep, dark hole, and you don't want to go there. Come on.
What do we do for money?
Stop being so scared of everything!
Yeah!
Right, like you're not scared.
I eat scared for breakfast, honey.
Yeah!
Let's go back in the house and make some rational decisions.
No!
I don't want rational decisions. I want dangerous, impulsive, crazy decisions.
Yeah!
Are you coming or not?
Look, I can't just run away like this. It's too crazy. I'm sorry.
Not as sorry as you're gonna be when you wake up and you're 46 and you're working for your father.
I can be impulsive. I just need to think about it first.
There you are. Secrets exposed. Marriages threatened. Delicious anarchy. But what happens now? Can this be repaired? Or do you all leave in an hour feeling vaguely depressed? Let's find out, shall we?
Isha.
Humiliated, shamed, mortified.
Oh, Kara.
I told that Beinecke woman we kept nothing from each other.
My sweet, my only. Wednesday wasn't too sure about the boy, so I didn't want to worry you.
Oh, and you didn't dare tell me because I'm such a terrible mother.
You are a wonderful mother.
And look at the thanks I get. I gave up everything for the sake of this family. I wanted to travel. I wanted to see Paris.
I never saw the sewers of Paris.
Oh,
and now
Cara.
It'll never happen.
Oh, Kara.
So this is how it ends. Alone and forgotten in a tiny room living off cat food and broken dreams. That's what happens to mothers. I mean, look at yours. She came for the weekend. The weeks turned into months. 12 years later, and she's still up there, deceived, deluded, smoking weed in the attic. A grandma. Well, I'm not going to end up like your mother.
My mother? I thought she was your mother. No, I'm serious.
You lied to me. I can't live with that.
Oh, come, Morticia. I have an urge to take you into my arms.
Not today.
But...
Out! Daughter's getting married. I can't believe it's true. She doesn't ask her mother before she says I do. And what about my husband? Oblivious, naive. This evening's getting serious. These Ohioans won't leave. Well, I won't let these latest troubles rob me of my bliss. For when I'm scared of true disaster, I remember this. Death is just around the corner, waiting patiently to strike. One unplanned electrocution, that's the kind of end I can comprehend when I'm feeling uninspired or I need a little spree. I'm reborn knowing death is just around the corner, coming after me. Get it? Corner? Death is just around the coroner. Death is just around the corner, waiting high up on the hill. Someone buried in an avalanche. That's the kind of gig I can really dig. Marriage often disappoints you. Not
that each husband is a gem. So I'll mourn knowing death is just around the corner coming after them. If life's all flumps, I'll muddle through some. But when death comes, I hope it's gruesome. Cha! Some people die from public stoning, faulty wiring, faulty zoning, cherry pits they didn't know were there. It could be by a jungle cat,
a slippery mat,
a baseball bat,
perhaps an unsuccessful love affair. It could be on a speeding train, it could be underwater, it could be too much Novocaine, or even by your daughter.
A title fly.
Religious right.
Why, darlings, it might even be tonight.
Death is just around the corner. No one's ever been immune.
Turning off the respirator.
I feel so dark. I feel so dead. All is black inside my face.
Boy, they really got to you. That doesn't even rhyme.
You got a problem with that?
I did not raise my son to be kidnapped by a bunch of left-wing creeped-out Spanish weirdos.
You didn't raise him, Mal. I did. You were at the office, remember?
I was at the office for you. For him. I had plans for the boy.
Oh, Mal, he's in love. Let him follow his heart.
Follow his heart? That's crazy.
What's wrong with crazy? Crazy is underrated.
Let me get this straight. Your son, your only son, wants to marry someone who is named after a day of the week and runs around Central Park with a crossbow. And you're okay with all of that?
If it makes him happy, yes.
Well, you better come to your senses, or I'm gonna have to take steps.
Good idea. Why don't you start by taking steps outside?
What?
You wanna act like a tool? Go sleep in the shed. Mal!
What?
Oh, nothing.
Storm's passed. Think I'll get a little moon. Ladies, hello. Oh.
Yoo-hoo! Are you hiding? Are you playing with me, my only one? There she is, lovely, is she not? And so far away. Yes, in matters of love, my dears, distance is our friend. Closeness, no thank you. A quarter of a million miles away. That's a good distance for romance. We never fight. Each waning is a heartbreaking separation.
Aww.
Each meeting, a happy reunion.
Aww.
When the day light ends and the moon ascends, I would rather be just the moon and me. When I feel her pull, then my heart is full, and the night is softly, sweetly calling. Fester, look and see. La 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 la. It's a dream that's coming true when the moon says, I love you. There's more, though I'm told it's wrong. When I sing my song, she accepts, she attends, she believes, she befriends. La la la.
Where do you think you're going?
Away!
Elopement?
Daddy, would you just please?
No, this is what happens when you keep secrets. If you and that boy wanted to get married, you should have just...
There's not gonna be any marriage!
What? Why?
He bailed.
He bailed? A breach of promise! An outrage!
He thought running away was a bad idea.
Well, on the other hand, he does have a point.
I hate him!
Well, it's... a start, something to build off of.
He said he can't live without me, and then he lets me go. I love him, why doesn't he love me?
You just said you hated him. Which is it?
Both.
Ah, now you've got it. Right and wrong, who's to say which we should refuse? All we know, love survives either way we choose. Here you are at the edge, go ahead and fall. Don't resist, I insist, love still conquers all. It even conquered you, my adorable Attila. You had to go and grow up.
And you're cool with that?
Yes. And no. I'm feeling happy. I'm feeling sad. A little childish. A little dad. I think of all the days you've known, all the ways you've grown. See you on your own, and then I'm feeling happy and sad again. I think I'm rested, but then I'm tired. Today requested, tomorrow fired. And then some boy says he adores she who once was yours. How can I ignore such news? I'm feeling happy and sad. Why should I choose? Completely happy and a tiny bit sad.
How long have you been standing in the shadows?
My whole life.
You should be a writer. Have you met my daughter Wednesday? She is the greatest thing that will ever happen to you. Don't screw it up.
Yes?
Look, I can't stand the idea of not being with you.
5 minutes ago you could.
No, but see, the lover always comes back. Ulysses, Tristan, Romeo.
Listen, I'm homeschooled. What's your point?
I'd rather die than live without you.
Okay, prove it.
What?
Prove it. Here. Put this apple on your head and go stand against the tree.
Wait, you're gonna...
Uh-huh.
You're crazy.
And you're not crazy enough. That's the problem. Once I was hopeful, thought we were one. Now I wonder, are we undone? I want to treasure you in death as well as life. I want to catch you with my love and with my knife. Now can I live as your tormentor and your wife? I am crazier than you. I'm crazier than you. And nothing up till now has proved me wrong. I am crazier than you.
Deranged.
I never asked that of you.
But in this moment, I feel I've changed. I want to climb Mount Everest, go to Mozambique. I want to be impulsive, want to be unique. Can you believe I mean it when you hear me shriek? I'm crazier than you. I'm crazier than you. And now I'll prove to you exactly how. You can do. From here on in, I give my solemn vow. Ow, ow, ow.
The apple in your head, hold it in your hand, be brave.
The apple, not the liver, or we're dancing on my grave.
Place it in the bow and steady.
Can't you shoot that thing already?
I'm gonna demonstrate that fear is my idea.
Girl, believe me, fear is your
appeal. From the moment that you're frightened, life is real.
Then my life must be real, real,
and in flesh when you release and seal the deal.
Wait, you want crazy? Here's crazy.
Okay, now it's getting interesting. Aren't you afraid?
You know why? Because I'll guide the arrow. I'll guide it with my love.
How does that work exactly?
We're connected, see? We're destined to be together, so yeah, nothing bad can happen.
What if I miss?
Then you'll be the last thing I ever see.
That is so hot!
Ready?
Oh my God!
Gotcha. Now will you marry me?
Oh yes, Lewis, 1,000 times yes!
Lucas! Lucas!
Gotcha!
Did you hear that? The boy was willing to die for love. Hard to believe he's your son.
He was so happy.
Remember that? Being happy?
Yeah. What happened?
You've turned into an unfeeling, rigid, selfish control freak. Duh.
Fester, you're a wise person. How can I fix this? What do I do?
Don't worry. It'll come to you.
You know, I wasn't always this way. I was happy-go-lucky once. I played the guitar, told jokes, slept until noon. When you get a wife, a kid, a mortgage.
Keep going.
But what do I say?
Just remember how you felt the first time you saw her.
Alice, it's Mal.
I know.
No, the old Mal.
The old Mal? With the guitar and the t-shirt?
And the headband.
Oh my God, the headband! You were pretty crazy back then, you know that.
Yeah, I know. I guess I got stuck, Alice, more than most men. But Mama, I swear I'll be crazy again.
Mal, you're rhyming!
For you, baby, just for you. I learned from Lucas. I learned from you. I wasn't happy. I wasn't true. But then the way you spoke at dinner touched my soul. Completely crazy, yet completely in control. So when you kicked me out, I said, let's rock and roll. I'm crazier than you. I'm crazier than you. It warms me up to see you living large. When I'm crazier than you, far crazier than you, I'll drop the plan, you'll be the man in charge.
All this time and all I needed was the hope that you'd submit.
Too afraid and too conceited to believe that you were it. But the journey's now completed.
Oh Mal, I missed you, pumpkin. Come to mama.
I'm gonna treasure you in death as well as life. I'm gonna cut you with my love and with my knife. Can you live as my tormentor and my wife? I am crazier than you. I'm crazier than you. And live or die, I'll let you have control. I'm crazier than you. So say you love me too. From here on in, you're singing to my soul.
What's wrong, my little cockroach?
I can't sleep.
Why not?
There's no monster in the closet.
Well, I'm sure he's hiding someplace else.
Mommy, I have a full disclosure.
Yes?
What if you tried to do something to somebody and you ended up doing it to somebody else by mistake?
Are we talking about anyone we know?
Well, I was talking to Grandma before and she told me—
Don't listen to that ancient woman. She might not even be a part of this family.
Mommy, is Wednesday really gonna marry that guy?
She might.
Oh no, make me feel better, Mommy.
Life is a tightrope, my child. And at the other end is your coffin.
Better. Uh-huh, thanks, Mommy.
Now go to sleep, or the monster won't come out to eat you up. Pugsley? Pugsley? Sleep well, my little vermin. Your mommy's life has fallen apart and she needs to go away for a while. And years from now, when your marriage collapses and you're wondering who put us all on the road to hell, you can thank your father. Take care of my baby, will you? Keep him in harm's way.
One little secret, and she throws me out. What was I to do? I was trapped. But Morticia, my love, I make it up to you. You want to see the world? Done! You want to see sewers? I will show you sewers fit for a queen. Lurch! That hotel guide. Hotel Merde. Rue de Toilette, condemned 6 times by the Board of Health. Not enough. Aha! Voila! Hotel Nosferatu. No staff, no towels, no room service. Bingo! The worst hotel in Paris. Quick, Lurch, get them on the line. Is that my call? Hello? Hotel Nosferatu? Yes! Quickly! The future of my marriage is at stake!
Go fast! Go fast! Morticia's leaving!
What?
She's at the gate with the police! It's the end of the family!
Quick! Lead me to her, Fester! Quick! Quickly! Lead me! Quick!
Fester,
run!
The big boy! He can't run that fast!
So, it is true.
I can't live with a man who lies.
Well, there is another secret I have not told you.
What?
That you are the most magnificent, most beautiful, and most exquisite of all women.
That's no secret.
Well, yes, but even you had a secret once.
Never.
And if you're wrong?
I never am.
But if you are, what do I get?
Name it.
A dance.
Go on.
Well, many years ago, when you first met me and we fell in love and wanted to get married, we told your father, and he said, "Oh, wonderful, let's go and tell your mother." And what did you say?
How could I possibly remember what I
said? You said, "Oh no, she'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing."
That's different. My mother was condescending, judgmental, and loved nothing more than to stir up trouble.
Oh God, I've turned into my mother.
And Wednesday is you. Isn't it wonderful?
You did that like a lawyer.
No, just a husband. And father. Not so easy, in fact. Very difficult. Let's live before we die. Let's laugh before we cry. Let's hold each other tight and dance. If I have caused you pain, it's easy to explain. Come fill me with delight and dance. My love, my wife, forever you will be. But Wednesday's life, that too is part of me. To woman I adore and swore to suffer for, let's end this tug of war and dance.
Mother told me to beware of clever men with silver tongues.
Well, what I lack in depth, I make up for in shallowness.
You really think you could sway me with a joke?
It's the last thing I try before chloroform.
Tomorrow I may be in rainy gay Paris.
Please stay right where you are and dance.
I'm not a castanet who clicks with no regret.
You're more than that by far, so dance.
The place
wherein can never be what was, till we begin to do what dancing does. My darling, I was bad, bad husband and bad dad. Instead of being sad,
alone
we're lost, we're drifting out to sea.
But
side by side, we're gloomy as can be. As gloomy as can be. Morticia, I was wrong. I knew it all along. Forgive me with a song.
And dance.
My love, creature of constant surprises, you have legs!
Ladies.
Thank you.
Addams, you've changed our lives.
How can we ever thank you?
Tell your friends. Word of mouth is so important. Come, young lady, step forward and speak the words that every mother longs to hear.
I'm sorry.
You really want to marry this boy?
I do.
But why?
He's willing to die for me. Mother, I need to ask you something.
Yes.
Go on, just ask her.
Can we have your blessing?
Of course. And may you have many children, and may they give you as much grief as you have given us.
Attention, everybody. I have a full disclosure. I'm bringing my beautiful wife to Paris.
Oh, Gomez, the sewers!
Special package, one day, seven nights.
De temps, mon cher. De temps toujours.
Oh, oh, the French!
Okay, fun seekers. My acrimonium was missing, so I snuffed around. Tell them what happened, you little bedbug.
You're all so smart, you figure it out.
Okay, let's see. You were afraid you'd lose your sister.
So you stole my acrimonium.
To make Wednesday and Lucas fall out of love with each other.
But I never got to drink it because...
I passed it to my mother.
And I drank it and became who I really am.
Which made me fall in love with my family all over again.
And I reached deep into my reservoir of womanly compassion and bathed your father in forgiveness.
Welcome to our family. We are not losing a daughter. We are gaining three new Beinekes. Young man, for purely selfish motives, you turned this simple dinner party night into a night from hell.
We couldn't be more proud.
Hugsley, you're an artist. You rearranged life itself, and it all came out even. You're the best brother in the world.
So you're still gonna torture me?
Of course, until you get a girl of your own.
Oh.
Move towards the darkness. Welcome the unknown. Face your blackest demons. Find your bleakest bone. Lose your inhibitions. Love what once was vile. Move towards the darkness and smile. When you face your nightmares, then you'll know what's real. Move towards the darkness and feel. You rang, and I answered.
Yes, Lord, yes! Fester, where are you going?
I'm embracing the unknown. I'm moving toward my darkness.
Au revoir, Fester. May you find your bliss.
Excuse me, Fester, but where are you going?
To the moon, Alice.
Huxley, will you do the honors? I'm coming, my love. Stay full.
Fly, my lunatic brother. Fly on the wings of love. Are you unhappy, my darling?
Oh, yes. Yes, completely.